Hey everyone! In this video, we'll look at a FlipperZero JavaScript for copying and running payloads. We use JavaScript to copy an MP3 payload file from our Flipper's SD card onto a virtual USB disk. Once our payload is ready, we wait for the Flipper to detect the host machine. Once detected, we'll launch PowerShell commands to extract the IP address of the computer along with any saved Wi-Fi passwords. Next, BadUSB types the commands to detect the Flipper's virtual USB disk, and once it's detected, it will copy that MP3 payload onto the local computer. And then once that payload is copied onto the local computer, it will start playing that file. It will also copy the Wi-Fi data back onto our Flipper, and once everything's complete, it will eject the USB drive. When the Flipper detects that the USB drive was ejected, it will display the IP address and the Wi-Fi passwords. It will also copy them into the loot.txt in the same folder as the script. We'll start by looking at how to configure the script, and then we'll talk about the JavaScript features we use to make this all possible. Let's get started. I'll put a link to the JavaScript in the video description. My script requires some improvements that are currently only in the Momentum firmware. Many of the ideas from the script also came from Momentum Discord server, so I encourage you to check out their server. The first configuration we have is the keyboard layout, and for the demo I used a UK keyboard. The Momentum team added this feature last night, so we no longer have to use Alt Print to enter symbols on a non-US keyboard. This runs much faster. Next, we have the temp folder that gets created on the computer. We also have the name of the file to log information that will be sent back to our Flipper. Next, we have an array of script commands to run on the computer. Make sure there's a comma at the end of each line. If you use quote marks in your command, be sure to use backslash quote. This first command gets the IP addresses, and the second command gets the Wi-Fi passwords. Set copy payload to true if you want to copy the payload file to your computer. Set pay payload to true if you want to play the music. Payload name is the name of your file, which should be copied to that payload subdirectory on your SD card. Payload dest name is the location of the file on the virtual USB disk. Currently, the script only supports putting it in the root directory. The script's output will be appended to the loot file on the Flipper's SD card. Exfil capacity is the number of megabytes to reserve for the virtual USB disk, so increase this if your payload is larger than 4 megabytes, and you shouldn't need to modify the remaining parameters. That's it for configuration. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out on my Discord server. For the next part of the video, we'll take a look at how this script works. We use storage exist to see if the virtual USB disk file already exists. And if it does, we remove the file with storage remove. Next, we create the image for the desired capacity. If the user wants to copy the payload file, we'll use storage virtual init and storage virtual mount to mount that file, which will show up as /mnt/. Next, we'll copy the payload onto that mounted path. And then we call storage virtual quit to unmount the drive. Next, we set up our BadUSB, specifying the vendor ID, product ID, manufacturer name, product name, and the keyboard layout. We print waiting for connection, and then we loop waiting for a connection, retrying once a second. We print launching PowerShell and wait 3 seconds to make sure the keyboard's detected. We press Windows X and then I to open PowerShell. Next, we print running commands. Then we make a temp folder and change directory into it. We loop over our script array, typing each of those commands. For the demo, this gets the IP addresses and the wireless passwords. We then press enter a couple of times. We run a script that keeps searching for the USB disk from the Flipper. Once it's found, we assign the drive letter. If copy payload is true, we copy the payload from the USB disk to the local drive. If pay payload is true, we use the media player to play the song. If we ran at least one script, we'll copy the output back on the USB disk. Next, we eject the USB disk, and then we'll try to remove evidence that our script ran. We wait 10 seconds so there's time to troubleshoot if there's an issue, and then we close the window. We disable BadUSB and then wait 5 seconds. All of that script we've typed is still waiting for that USB drive to attach, so now we attach that storage. Our PowerShell commands are now running, and eventually they'll end up doing that eject on line 152, and at that point we'll exit this loop. Since the disk was ejected, we'll call USB disk stop and then wait 1 second. And then if we ran any script commands, we'll mount that USB image, and then we'll read that mounted result file into an array. We'll then create an empty text box, and then we'll populate it with the data from that array. Then we'll show the text box, and we'll append the data to our loop file as well. We'll wait for the text box to be dismissed with the back button, and then storage virtual quit will unmount our USB drive. At this point, our script is done. If you're a C programmer, I've got one more bonus section for you. Otherwise, if you could take a moment to like and subscribe, I'd really appreciate it. Midnight yesterday, storage.copy got added to the Momentum firmware, but I wanted to show briefly how you could add APIs that are not currently in JavaScript. JavaScript has the foreign function interface, or FFI, and you have to write out the method signature using keywords like void, char, and int. So there's nothing like uint32t, just say int. And instead of object name asterisk, just say void asterisk. I defined record open, record close, file stream alloc, stream free, file stream open, stream copy full. I also defined enumeration values, but you have to be very careful since these are typically ordered lists and a different firmware may have a different ordering, a different numerical assignment. So open existing is one in our firmware, but delete might be one in another firmware. So be very careful that these IDs are the correct IDs for the firmware you're running on. And then the rest of our code just looks like C code written in JavaScript. I'd love it if you could take a moment to like and subscribe on this video. Also, be sure to join my Discord server, and I also recommend the Momentum Discord server for their scripting area. And a huge shout out to the Momentum team, especially Willie, for helping check in those late night fixes so I could make this video for this week.